Hi, I'm Larry Puckett, the DCC Guy. Well, last week we took a look at the new Alpha Mimic lighting kit from DCC Concepts. And in one of the comments afterwards, somebody asked me whether or not you could use the Woodland Scenics Just Plug lights along with the structure lights from DCC Concepts. So that set me off on a quest for an answer to determine whether or not I'd be able to find a way to hook up the Woodland Scenics lights along with the Alpha Mimic lights from DCC Concepts. So come on along on my quest and we'll see whether or not I got it to work. Let's go ahead and get started with this. And the first thing I want to show you is a little notice right here on the bottom of the second page, and it's this block of text in red. And the last line is what's important because it says that if you choose to use LEDs other than those provided with the Alpha Mimic kit, that you need to keep the total output or the total load to less than 75 milliamps. Now that's important, and that's 75 milliamps per output. Now what do they mean per output? Because there are two sockets for each address on the board. Well, that output means per address. So you need to stay under a total of 75 milliamps for your LEDs for the entire address, for both sockets to an address. If you go ahead and do as I show and wire one set of LEDs straight through, so that they are of the same polarity as the socket itself. And the other one, if you reverse wire those LEDs, as I showed you, so that both sets can be on continuously, then the most you can have on at a time for those two sockets would be three LEDs. Now, why three? Well, white LEDs, like the ones that we are using here, and I'll talk about these guys here. These are the, this is one of the, just plug LEDs. It's a gooseneck lamp, and it uses a single white surface mount LED down inside here. I don't know if you can see that. It's extremely small. But at any rate, a white LED, and just about all LEDs, typically operate at about 20 milliamps. Now, they'll come on at 10, and they'll burn up to about 30. And once you get up to 30, they're probably not going to burn very long. So you want to try to go for something around 20 milliamps. So 20 milliamps times three of these gives you 60. And that's going to keep you under that 75 milliamp total. Now, you know, pushing it, you might get four operating at 75 without any problem. I'm not going to do that. And that way, I know that I'm not going to exceed the 75 milliamp total. Now, I hope that's clear, because it's something that you need to think about when you're setting these boards up. Okay, now, how do we go about trying to connect one of these little guys directly to the board? Well, first off, if you look here, there's a very long, at several feet of wire here attached to this little gooseneck. And let me zoom in so you can see what I'm talking about here. So we've got a lot of wire here wrapped around this piece of cardboard that is attached to this gooseneck, and it's red and black, so you can observe polarity. And you'll see right here on the end, I'll see if I can get these down here, we've got these little fine bare wires right here. There's a red and a black that have been stripped. And the way that these work, they typically, those bare wires would be inserted into these little holes here in what's called a linker plug. And this is what is used with the just plug lights to connect them to the just plug fixtures. And they have a little hole, and you put one of those bare wires, the red one, you simply push the little button in, the red button, and put the red wire in that one, release it and it grips it. Push the black one here, put the black wire in here, and it grips it, and you've got a connection, and that's all it is. Unfortunately, though, this will not fit the sockets on the Alpha Mimic board. So what are our options? Well, what I'm going to do today is I'm going to just cut this off, and I'm going to reattach a set of wires using this one here or one of the extras from the kit. It that's left over, because, you know, anytime you you splice two of the LEDs that come with the board together to one set of to one harness like this, you're going to have an extra one left over. So you can use one of these, or I found these several years ago on eBay, and I'll show you the package because it was so long ago that there's no record on eBay of my purchase anymore. So these were under www.eboot.me. They're a Chinese company that were selling at the time. And you can see these are a 1.25 millimeter pin spacing here with a 10 centimeter wire attached. So that's how long that wire is, about 10 centimeters. And they're talking about the spacing here on the pins is 1.25 millimeters. So that's what you'd want to look for if you're looking for a JST connector with a 1.25 millimeter pin spacing. So that's what you would need in order to fit the Alpha Mimic board. But, you know, the easiest thing to do is just use one of the leftover ones that come with the Alpha Mimic kit itself. Now, of course, the other thing you could do is take the two bare wires here that we've got and splice them onto one of these harnesses, and just like you would the ones that come in the kit. So that would be one way to do it. Okay, and I will show you how to do this, and I will show you how to connect one of these, and then we'll test it out with the Alpha Mimic board and see if it actually is going to work for us. Okay, let's go ahead. I'm going to get my soldering iron out, set it up here, and we'll start doing some soldering. I'm going to go ahead and start with the linker plug. And again, all you need to do is just take and cut it off right here like this, and you'll end up with something like this. I went ahead and cut this off in advance. Sorry, I jumped the gun on that. And then I'm going to go ahead and we'll strip the insulation off of these a little bit, like this, and like that. And I'm going to use one of these shorter ones and reverse wire it. And I want it to be the opposite of the one where I'm going to use the standard polarity harness from DCC Concepts. So let's go ahead and we'll do that. Okay, let's go ahead and pre-tin these wires and get them ready to use. And for that, just going to heat up a little bit of solder on these wires. And that makes it a very, very quick procedure when you get ready to connect the two together. Okay, got that done. There. Let's go ahead and make the final connection here with these. And for that, I'm going to use my special tool here that's got these alligator clips on it. And it's great because it will hold these wires while I do the soldering. So you can see there's the two wires right there held in the little alligator clip. Now, let's go ahead and almost forgot to add the heat shrink tubing to these. And I'll add the red here and a piece of black here. There we go. And now I can do the soldering here. Get rid of that excess solder. Like that. And we'll do the black here. Okay, so those are now soldered. They're cool enough. We can bring up the heat shrink tubing over them. Like this. And as I've showed you in the past, I just take the tip of my soldering iron back behind the silver part and just shrink that heat shrink tubing right on down there. So this gives you a good protection against shorts, and it also strengthens the joint a bit because that heat shrink tubing does add some physical protection as well as electrical. Okay, and that's all there is. Before we go on, I want to ask you to take a moment to subscribe to the channel. It's simple, easy, and free. All you have to do is hit that little red subscribe button, and when the little bell comes up, click on it and click all. Thanks now. So here's the red wire in my right hand. I'm going to insert that in there and let it go. There we go. Now, we'll do the black one. Push in on the button and insert the wire deep. Release the button and that's it. Now it's ready to be plugged in to the DCC Concepts Alpha Mimic board, and we'll see if that one works. But first, we've got another one to do. Now for this second one, I'm going to use this pole lamp. So it's going to be used in the area outside of the gas works. We want to go ahead and tin these exposed wires here. Traditionally, magnet wire was coated with lacquer, but I think nowadays they're probably using plastic, but I'm not sure of that. There we go. That looks ready. And for this connection, I'm going to use one of the harnesses that come with the Alpha Mimic board. So once again, I'm going to insert that here in my wire holder. And let's go ahead and make this connection after I insert or add the heat shrink tubing here. And once again, I will go ahead and do the heat shrink tubing so that we've got a good connection here that is protected. And we'll heat shrink that, we'll shrink that tubing down as I showed you before. Okay, and with that, we now have the Just Plug pole lamp ready to go and the gooseneck lamp ready to go. So what I'm going to do is move over to the modules and we'll test these out on the Alpha Mimic board and make sure everything works before I install them on the layout. Here we are back over in front of the module at the gas works where I installed the lights last week. And I've gone ahead and connected the pole lamp, which is wired straight through using the Alpha Mimic harness that came with the kit. I've attached it to one of the sockets here on the board, and I've added the gooseneck lamp, which is reverse wired, to the second socket. So both of these should light up at the same time. So let me go ahead and turn on the board and we'll see what happens. Okay, as you can see here, we've got light from both of these. So it looks like the quest was a success. We've got the lights working. And the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead and install these here on the module at the gasworks. I'll be using the existing hole for the gooseneck lamp. And I'm going to put it, let me show you where I'm going to install it. I'm going to install it right over the door here on the gasworks. And the pole lamp, I'll put this out here on the edge, on the corner of the building, so that it's going to illuminate this area. We don't want it over there where the vehicles are going to be coming and going. I might be able to put one, an additional one over here somewhere. We'll see in the future, but there's plenty of outlets on here to work with. So let me go ahead and get my drill out, and we'll punch a hole for the pole lamp. I've moved the building back a little bit. I'm going to put a hole right here for the pole lamp using this 3/32 drill bit. Okay, and that's all there is to that installation. So the next thing, I'm going to have to unravel all these wires and we'll run the wires through. I'm going to pull this off of the layout and I've got to drill a mounting hole right here. And so back in a second. As you can see here, I drilled this small 1/16 inch diameter hole above the door where I'm going to mount that gooseneck lamp. So it's going to shine the way for people going in and out of the office door here. And right here, I've got my pole lamp. And there's a problem here. And the problem is that this plug is not going to fit down through that 3/32 inch hole that I drilled. So what I'm going to have to do is I'm just going to cut these wires here and strip them down bare again, feed them through the hole that I drilled, and connect them to the Alpha Mimic board. So what I want to do then is I'm going to cut through the connections here, the solder joints, and bare those wires, run them down through, and then just attach them to the same linker plug that I'm using for the gooseneck. And that's going to allow me to use the two LEDs on the same outlet. So let's give that a try and see how it's going to work. Okay, here's the final scene. So you can see the gooseneck lamp over top of the door there is really doing a nice job of illuminating that area. You can see it's got the whole door area illuminated. Here you can see the light on the pole lamp quite brilliantly shining there and illuminating the yard. So you'll notice I did decide to move it. I originally had thought of putting it here, but I think it fits better in that location so that the folks loading Coke or delivering things to the gasworks will be able to see what the heck they're doing. So at this point, we've got all the lights working and nothing seems overly bright to me. So I think we're in very good shape as far as the life of these LEDs. I don't think that they're going to burn out early. I think we're getting a very good illumination from them. So one of the great things about this kit is the flexibility. So you're able to use the LEDs that come with the kit, and you can also use the Just Plug lights or any other type of LED that you choose to use on your model railroad to illuminate structures and yards and anything else as far as that goes. So go ahead, take a look at the Alpha Mimic lighting kit available from DCC Concepts in the U.S. again. Iron Planet Hobbies has it, and I'll point out they have it on sale through, I believe, the end of the year. So if you're interested in this, now would be a great time. Go to the ironplanethobbies.com website and look up the Cobalt Alpha Mimic kits for lighting. And for you guys in the UK, of course, you can order these kits from DCC Concepts, any of the hobby shops over there that carry their products. And I believe that you can probably find the Just Plug lights at any hobby shop that stocks Woodland Scenics products, or at least they can order them. And the great thing is these Just Plug lights are available in a number of different types. You have the pole lamp like I show here. You've got the gooseneck lamp, which is a basic industrial type fixture. They have a wide range of different light types that you can purchase and obviously use with your Alpha Mimic boards. So it greatly expands the use of your boards and your lighting capabilities on your model railroad. And you can also take a look at the range of products that Woodland Scenics makes in the Just Plug line on their website. Well, that's a wrap for today's video. So now you know that you can safely use these Just Plug lights from Woodland Scenics along with the lights that DCC Concept sells for use with their Alpha Mimic boards. And you can do it safely as long as you follow the warnings that DCC Concepts provides in the instructions. So take a look at those, take a look at the system at dccconcepts.com, and have a great week, have a great weekend. We'll see you here next week with another video from the DCC Guy. Bye now.